So ringing in the new year for Stadia is going to come with something that this platform just isn't used to seeing quite yet, especially for the Stadia users. We've seen a lot of Stadia games releasing, especially the last 4 months, but the entire 2021 will be riddled with games dropping left and right. And today we're going to be bringing news of four more titles that were rated for Stadia, including one that does get asked quite a bit about. With that, make sure you guys stay up to date with Stadia news by subscribing to the fastest growing Stadia and cloud gaming channel, as I do make daily videos and gently tap that like button. So if you're new to my Stadia news videos, I cover a lot of games that get rated before they actually get announced. This is how we get breaking news on a lot of titles, and today's going to be no different, as we got word of four different games rated for Stadia. And keep in mind, these ratings are the first step before you see them launch, but they could come either right away or later down the line. We'll start with a game that was popular a year ago in Football Manager 2020, but now sees the new Football Manager rated here in Football Manager 2021. This was an interesting title, to say the least, on Stadia, because last year it boasted the ability to have faster processing throughout the game that you normally can get with your PC or console due to the processing power Stadia has, making it much quicker to do multiple simulations. I would fully expect to see that perk continue on Stadia with the 2021 version. Not only that, but FM21 is boasting a brand new match engine, new AI improvements across every area of the pitch, and even more data to help you analyze your team's performance. I got to play FM2020 last year, and it was easily my most downvoted gameplay video, as people saw how much I sucked and how insane this game is. It's so detailed, but in a good way, and it can definitely be overwhelming for someone new to the series. But either way, hopefully we will see this one soon drop on the Stadia library. And like always, guys, stay tuned, because I will have coverage, as bad as it potentially may be. So Epistory the Typing Chronicles also got rated with Peggy, and it's no surprise to see this one, as Nanotale's Typing Chronicles is an officially confirmed game headed to Stadia. But Epistory is a game that is a little bit older. Interestingly enough, it's much more highly regarded, with over 3,000 positive user reviews. It's an atmospheric action RPG, but the kicker is that the game is controlled essentially with just the keyboard, and you'll be typing your way through battles and solving puzzles. Both Epistory and Nano are, as I keep saying, very, very interesting titles on Stadia, considering most of the gamers who use the platform are controller-based, but I for one will be intrigued to test both of these games out, as I do 95% of my gaming via my computer with Stadia, so I'll be looking to try these out here pretty soon when they finally do arrive, and it'll be interesting to see how they play out with just the keyboard aspect of the game. So Surviving the Aftermath got rated for Stadia via Peggy, and I talked a little bit about this game before. It's a post-apocalyptic strategy game that came out in October 2020 as an early access game, and in this game you're going to be managing your colony by sending people to scavenge for resources. You'll be building up your defenses, you'll even be fighting off bandits and other rival groups. Think of course like Walking Dead. It's a game that perked me up immediately, because I love the setting and I love strategy games, especially since this is from Paradox Interactive, the publisher of the Crusader Kings series. This is an extremely popular franchise, one that I was introduced to this year, and I think I spent a good 40 to 50 hours on the new Crusader Kings 3. So for me, this is a title that I have big time on my radar if it does hear release. It got bombed though in the user reviews when it released in early access, riddled with bugs, and the gameplay was something that people just didn't enjoy, but has recently started to see more positive reviews, as it looks like they've been hard at work on fixing the game. Keep in mind, again, this is an early access title, which Stadia doesn't have a ton of, but it's not unheard of course to see that. I'm going to be paying extreme close attention to this title. I really hope that we continue to see more Paradox Interactive games, as I probably would scream like a schoolgirl if we got to see the Crusader King titles on Stadia. These are some amazing games, so we'll definitely be keeping an eye out on this one. So this one admittedly was rated a few weeks ago on Peggy, and I'm just getting around to letting you guys know about it. Invector is a musical title featuring 25 tracks from Avicii, 6 worlds that you can tackle, and there's also a 4-player split screen mode. It's a title that reminds me of Thumper that's currently on Stadia, and Avicii himself, that's my favorite type of music, so I'll be definitely giving this one a shot. And I'm noticing a trend with Stadia and musical games, like one hand clapping, there's shapes and beats, and then of course we have harmonics that's making a Stadia exclusive game, and that's the makers of Rock Band and Guitar Hero. I for one don't disapprove of these types of games. Last thing I want to mention before ending this video is that there was a big list that was leaked by Peggy for Stadia games some time ago. A few of the titles that I talked about on this video were on there, but some have already released as well. So of course this continues to lend credence to the fact that all these games that I'm talking about here in this video are probably coming out for Stadia, hopefully very soon. Example of course being Surviving the Aftermath, like I just covered. Also, another game that was on that big list was Saints Row the Third, and I'm really hoping for that one to come out in the days and weeks ahead. Also, it looks like I just got word of this and having to post edit my video, looks like El Hijo was added to the January's pro game lineup, bringing the total games for the month to 5 games in total, including F1 2020, RE and the Secret of Seasons, Figment, and Hotline Miami. This makes a ton of sense, as usually we've gotten 5 or 6 games, so it was a bit unusual to see only 4 for the month of January, but it looks like El Hijo, a game pretty brand new, has joined the pro lineup, and this game has been getting good marks. Make sure you guys do go to the Stadia store and go ahead and claim these games right away. With that, let me know which of these games you guys are most excited for, and let me know which games you guys hope to continue to see. Like always, I'm Sunny, and I'll see you guys in the cloud.